edition of Korea's Housing Market Report. I'm your host, Matt Day, and joining me once again is Korea's senior economist, Sean Cathcart. Sean, how are you doing today?
Doing great, Matt.
That's good. We're going to take a quick look at national home sales activity over MLS systems of Canadian real estate boards and associations for January 2020. So the first month of the year, brand new year, what were we seeing out there?
After adjusting for normal seasonality, national home sales declined by 2.9% in January compared to December. So that's not a small decline, but remember it falls on the heels of a pretty strong rally last year. January sales still stood among some of the stronger monthly readings we've had in the last few years. And if you just look at the month of January alone on an unadjusted basis historically, it was actually the best start to any year since 2008. Another thing to consider is that there's evidence that some of the slowdown in sales this winter is simply because there's a real shortage of properties for sale in many parts of the country at the moment.
Yeah, and that seems to be a growing concern. I think we've heard that from realtors. So, but we're going to talk about what's going on in local markets.
Well, the biggest influence on the national result in January was a slowdown in Greater Vancouver and the Fraser Valley, although supply is less of an issue in this case. It's only 1 month at this point, but we'll be keeping a close eye on that one. Elsewhere, there was sort of a mixed bag of smaller gains and declines, but like I mentioned before, some of the places where we might have expected more sales and where we know demand is very strong right now, there's very little inventory, and so and new listings are also very low. It's something we've seen before with tight markets in the winter, where many owners of very scarce and thus highly desirable properties are likely going to hold off until at least the spring when the weather is better and they're going to get more traffic. So deferred listings mean deferred sales, and you can't buy what isn't up for sale yet. So I guess we'll have to revisit this topic a little later this year.
Yeah, I think it's safe to say we're going to keep an eye on that and we'll look at things as we get into spring, which is typically the busier selling season. Shifting over to back to the markets tracked by the MLS Home Price Index, what can you tell me about that?
Sure. Well, in line with tightening market conditions in many parts of the country, the MLS Home Price Index climbed another 0.8% in January, and that was the eighth consecutive monthly gain. As a result of that, the HPI is now up a cumulative 5.5% from the low point reached last May, and it's also set new all-time records in each of the past 6 months.
And so once again, something to keep an eye on, right? Okay, so what are we talking about? What price trends are we seeing in different parts of the country?
Sure. It's still a mixed bag, but generally things are firming almost everywhere, whether that means the end of a declining trend some places, accelerating gains elsewhere. Home prices have generally been stabilizing in most prairie markets in recent months following lengthy declines, although Regina is an exception where prices have recently taken another leg down. Home prices in British Columbia have been on the rise again since about last summer, and that goes double for Ontario's Greater Golden Horseshoe region, where a number of markets in and around the GTA are all of a sudden knocking on the door of double-digit gains again. And finally, further east, price growth in Ottawa, Montreal, Moncton, that's been going on for some time now. But Montreal, and particularly Ottawa, price growth has really strengthened in recent months.
Awesome. All right, Sean. Well, thanks for all the information. A lot to unpack this month. If you want to know more, head on over to korea.ca, or better yet, check with a realtor in your area. And we'll see you again in March.